Hello, everybody, and welcome to my balance sheet multi-step income statement creation. So over here, the information opinions in this presentation are those of the author only and not the author's employers or affiliated organizations, including but not limited to Irvine Valley College and the South Orange County Community College District. The presentation is for educational purposes only and does not constitute any legal or accounting advice whatsoever. This presentation is copyright 2008 to 2021 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. All rights are reserved. Any distribution is strictly prohibited. So in part one of my video, we did a classified balance sheet. And so, you know, it was right over here. And part of the reason why we went through and did, or why did I go through and do this classified balance sheet, is because that for my students, so that we can constantly review the preparation of the financial statements, and also just to kind of refresh the memory so that when we get to the final exam, it's not a big surprise, that the financial statements are extremely important in financial accounting. One of the things as being a managerial accounting instructor as well is that the multi-step income statement is absolutely critical for success. So preparing a multi-step income statement is also very, very important too. And this is where we kind of come into this part right here. Now notice there, the totals here don't balance because I'm kind of taking this somewhat out of, kind of doing this a little bit out of sequence. We're not doing a full financial statement preparation. I'm just giving you the information or the income statement accounts. But if we go over here, like what exactly is a multi-step income statement? A multi-step income statement is going to be an income statement where for a company like the Home Depot, where we have a retailer, you're going to see here net sales, meaning sales minus any sales returns, discounts or allowances, less our cost of goods sold or the cost of sale gives us gross profit, meaning how much did we make off of our inventory. And then we have our operating expenses. We have interest and other expense, earnings before income taxes, net earnings, et cetera, et cetera. So over here for Facebook, Facebook's income statement looks a little bit different because they're not selling, they're not going through and selling product. Right, Facebook is, well, they're selling our information, but they're essentially going through and they do different things. So when you look here at Facebook, the way that they're breaking out their costs and expenses is really going to be more along the lines of R&D, marketing and sales, G&A. Similarly with Apple, let's go back. I think their income statement might be first, right? You've got net sales, and then they've got products and services, and then the cost of those sales of the products and the services are going to be right over here, operating expenses, and then gross margin. And again, when we're doing these financial statements, it's for the investors. How do we give our investors the very best information? That's what we're looking to do. So let's go over here and take a look. Okay, so using the information below, create a multi-step income statement in proper form for the year end of December 31st, 2022. Assume that ZI had 100,000 shares issued and outstanding during the year. Determine earnings per share. And the one other thing I forgot over here, which I'm going to add right now, is assume a 20% income tax rate. Okay, so let's go through and have some fun. So we've got ZI. We're going to have income statement for the year ended 12/31/22. These amounts are not in thousands. These are the real numbers, so we don't have to worry about that part. Okay. The first thing we're always going to go through and do is we're going to determine net sales. We're going to do net sales minus cost of goods sold. So how do we figure that out? Well, we have sales revenue. My sales revenue was $10 million less sales returns and allowances, less sales discounts. This is going to give us our net sales. Okay, so right over here, So this is going to be negative 50. This will be negative 75,000. So our net sales are going to be 9,875,000. What I then do is I subtract less cost of goods sold. My cost of goods sold right over here is 5 million. This is going to give me gross profit. Okay. So right over here, this is my gross profit. This is what I'm making on my inventory sales. Again, I cannot tell you how important it is for you to understand this concept going into managerial accounting, at least my class. Okay. So over here, this is then going to be less selling, general, and administrative expenses. So for my SG&A, I'm going to have selling and general and administrative. So this is going to be 2. This is going to be 1.2. So I'm going to have total SG&A. And this is going to be 3.2 million. So let's kind of go again, do a little recap. Sales minus my sales returns and allowances minus my sales discounts. This is going to give me net sales. My net sales minus my cost of goods sold gives me my gross profit. When I add up my selling expenses plus my general and administrative expenses, I get total selling, general, and administrative expenses. So my operating income is going to be 4,875 less 1,675. Okay. Now, this is where it's going to be a little bit different. When we have financial statements and when we're going through and classifying things through, what you're going to notice is you got SG&A. You can call out depreciation and amortization separately if that's something that you want to do, not necessarily a bad idea. But then what you're going to have is this is your operating income. Then you're going to have other income and expense. So over here, other income slash expense, we're going to have interest revenue, and this will be 50,000. Then we're going to have interest expense, negative 5,000. Net other income is going to be a total of 45,000. Okay. So when we look at this over here, so this is net other income. So right over here, so that my net income before income taxes is going to be 1,675 plus 45, or 1,720. And okay, let's see if this is right. Well, we know that if we subtract these two amounts right here, we get 1,720. If I didn't give you a total column, right, you would add up the debits and you get a total over here of 8,330. You add up the credits and you get a total over here of 10,050. Subtract the smaller from the larger balance, and that's going to give you your net income before income taxes. Okay. So once I have this part over here, right? So this is my net income before income taxes. I'm going to then say less income tax expense. It tells me here that my income tax rate is 20%. So I'm going to take 1,720 times 0.2. Right? So 1,720. Times 20% gives me 344,000. Okay. That's where this value is coming from. So this is N times 20% equals O. Okay. So my net income after tax is going to be $1,720,000 minus 344. Now, what you'll notice here is that when you have, they call it sometimes different things, they'll call it net earnings. Here under Facebook, you'll see over here, they've got basically provision for income and taxes. They call it net income, income before provision for income taxes. So you're going to see it written out differently in a lot of different places. So it's just something that you want to, I could just call this net income if I wanted to. That's fine. Or net income after tax. I would accept either. It's the right thing. So here, I'm now done with this part right over here. So one of the things we also need to do as a company, and one of the more important things that we have to show, is something called earnings per share. Okay. So what is earnings per share? It basically tells us on a per share basis how much each of our shares earned. For this class, all you have to go through and do to compute earnings per share is you're going to take your net income, my net income after tax, and I'm going to divide it by my issued and outstanding shares. So over here, my earnings per share is $13.76. Let's go through this again. So to compute earnings per share, I'm going to take my net income after tax. I'm going to divide this by my common 100,000 shares. Or another way of saying this is my average shares outstanding. Okay, so right over here, 1,376,000. My common shares issued and outstanding. I'm generally would be doing this as an average. Okay, over here is 100,000. So my earnings per share is going to be 1,376,000 divided by 100,000 shares, or $13.76. I want to, we'll call this earnings per share basic, or basic earnings per share. So the, and again, I'm just introducing you to this concept of what is earnings per share. Why is it so important? Because when we look at different ratios to determine a company's valuation, right? The earnings, basic earnings per share for Home Depot for the 3 months ended November 1st is $3.20. If you hear about something called the price to earnings ratio, okay, that's where this number is coming into play. You take the price of the common stock, you divide it by the earnings per share. That is basically going to give you a judge in terms of, is stock overpriced? Is it underpriced? Okay. So this is my CLAP multi-step income statement classification. I want to thank you for watching. Please do not forget to like and subscribe, and I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a great one.